Sis Creates, and welcome to my second video. In this look, I'll be doing an eye tutorial on this cut crease, glitter cut crease glam, and a bunch of extraness with a red lip. And if you are not yet subscribed, please subscribe to my channel, like this, and leave a little comment, say hi, and give it a thumbs up too. I said like. Give it a thumbs up, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I have a special guest. She has been controlling the camera for me, and here she is, my sister Lily. You pop it. Do you want to pop it? Say hi.
Hi, I'm Lily.
You're not even in.
Oh, hi, I'm Lily Sisley's sister.
So yeah, let's get into this tutorial glam thing. So I did my face and my base and my brows and everything off of camera so we can just focus on the eye tutorial. So let's get started. The Morphe 35O palette, you can see. You can use any palette with nudes and dark colors because that's what we're going with today. We're going to do a, as I said before, a smoky eye and a glitter cut crease. And if you want to, you can definitely do a winged liner. I think I might be doing a winged liner, but off of camera. So let's go in with a transition color. I'm going to be using Sonia K blending brush. It's really tapered. I used this in my other tutorial. So I'm going to go in with two neutrals. These two nudes. You can use any nude color that's to your skin type. These two are the closest to mine, so I'm going to be using those. So next, I'm going to be going in with this brown shade right here as the next neutral color to make everything smooth. And on this brush, it's Mikasa E330. So I'm going to be running this through the, a little bit below the crease. Still concentrating and making sure this is blended out. I'll be going in with a darker shade. Probably these two combined, or most likely this one because it's lighter. Probably that one too. Like darker shades than the brown that we just used. Some cooler tones. And I'll be focusing that on the crease. I'll be using this Mikasa brush in E310. To really make sure that I still have the color, but it's blended out nicely without any harsh lines. Brush by Sonia K. It's more tapered and smaller, so it'll be perfect for getting to the outer corner of our eyes. So I'll be going in with any of these three, probably a mixture of these three dark shades to really concentrate our cut crease that we're gonna make. So let's do that. So I'll be going back with the Mikasa E320, the clean blending brush, and really soften up those edges. Make sure you go in with a light hand, or else it'll just be looking like recognized. So you have to have that nice soft mix of all the colors that we used. Now, if you don't like some of the harshness, or if it's too close to your brow, just clean it up with concealer or a little bit of highlight, and we'll do that later on. And if it's a little crazy, feel free to go in with the neutral colors or with the brown that we used after the neutral colors to really soften up the edges and to still have that brown in there, so it hasn't disappeared or anything. Going in with different brushes so that everything's nice and soft and everything's transitioned to each color that we used. Alright, so once we got everything nice and blended, you can leave it like this, or you can add some matte color in our lid, or you can do a cut crease and cut the lid with some concealer, any concealer of your choice. I'm just going to go in with the Avon True Color Avon Extra Lasting in the color Light, since you're not really going to see it, because we're going to put some glitter on top. I'm going to be going in with Maya Cosmetics. This really cute brand, and it's a glitter, so it might be a little messy, but it's okay, because it's totally worth it. And if we get some fallout, make sure you bake a little bit underneath your eyes so that you could just swipe it away. So let's cut this. I'm just going to be, I don't even know where I got this brush from, but it's really nice tapered brush. It's perfect for cleaning. It has no brand to it, but it is amazing brush to cut creases with. So I'm just going to be taking some on our hands. And it's okay if it's not perfect, because we can easily clean it up. And with the glitter, I'm also going to be using some strip lash adhesive with aloe vera lash glue. You can get it at Target or Walmart or anywhere you want. So before we go into the glitter, I'm going to be taking a shade, the glitter shade, I think this shade right here, it's the most gold, or you can go into the Modern Renaissance palette and use a combination of this one and this one. So you can use a combination of Vermeer and Primavera, but probably Primavera is the closest one you can do. So I'm going to mixture those two, and I'm going to pat it all over my lid. So that's going to be a base. So I have all my brushes in this thing. So that's going to be a base for when we add the actual glitter, we can use the eyelash glue. So let's do that first. Let's create a base for our glitter. Thank you. here's the tricky part. So we have to go back to the browns here. So a mixture of these colors and these two, or probably this one, to really fix and concentrate on the cut crease, and also to fix our outermost corner. So we're gonna go in with that. I'm gonna be taking the Sigma E310, the one that we used before, and really fix and smoke out this area here. More tapered brush, because in the packaging it has a little hole, so you can just put a brush in it like this color and grab it. Siberian gold in the color with a tiny brush, and I'm just going to highlight the brow bone and the inner corner of my eyes. So here's the eyeliner. So you have to be really careful because it is glitter and it will get on your lashes. So feel free to put on falsies. I definitely recommend it with this look, so that if you have some imperfections, you can definitely cover them up with some lashes, but still show the look. But since I don't have lashes at the moment, I will be using Better Than Sex mascara. And before we do that, we have to remember to put eyeshadow on our bottom lash line. So I'm gonna be doing that. Also, I'm gonna be lining up my waterline with the Sephora Contour Matte Gel Eyeliner that's waterproof. It's white. You can get it at Sephora, obviously. But you can also line your waterline with the black eye pencil. But for this look, I really want to do a pop of white in my look, so that it will bring it out more. So first, I'm going to be smoking out the bottom lash line. So I'm going to be using these two colors first, with the other Sonia, with the Mikasa E310, the one that we used previously, and then let's just start with that first. A little darker, go in with the more tapered Sonia K brush, and go in with any of these three browns, or a combination of all of them. Dramatic. I'm gonna be going in with Kat Von D red lipstick in the color Outlaw.